One chapter down and five to go. Let's continue our journey through Return of the Jedi with Chapter 2, The Great Pit of Carkoon. Episode 6, Return of the Jedi. Chapter 2, The Great Pit of Carkoon. Work continues on the new Death Star, and the future of the galaxy appears increasingly bleak. On Tatooine, Luke Skywalker is in the grip of Jabba the Hutt, along with Han Solo, Chewbacca, and Princess Leia. Jabba takes his prisoners across the Tatooine dunes to the Great Pit of Carkoon, where he plans to feed them to the fearsome Sarlacc beast. But even with backup from Boba Fett, Jabba has severely underestimated the powers of a Jedi. High up in the sand dunes of Tatooine sails Jabba the Hutt and his prisoners. Well, we're all tied up at the moment, and we're about to be fed to an enormous sand monster. Needless to say, our situation could certainly be better. And it looks like Luke is the first to take the plunge. That's a steep drop. But how are we going to get out of this? Why, it's very, very simple. With a little help from R2, all we need is a distraction. So we're going to use the plank as a trampoline. After all, gymnastics is an incredibly popular sport, according to the teachings of the Jedi. Ooh, what's this silver shiny thing? Can I take a look at it? What the heck? Doesn't work anyway. Psych! Let's do this! Charge! And we are thrown into a battle with Jabba's goons. So, one thing you need to know about this chapter is that you are going to be dealing with a lot of laser fire in this game. The first thing you need to do is take out any guards that appear on your sailor. Now we need to destroy these two boxes because when we build the piles of Lego whilst dodging all of the fire... Oh, jeez. Better get my lightsaber out. You can get rid of the guards, and that can temporarily buy you some time, but they will respawn. So you can't get rid of them permanently. I know, it sucks. Especially considering how much blaster fire you have to deal with. Alright, let's go ahead and build this turret. And there are four turrets to assemble. Also, another lever to assemble. Aside from Luke, we also have Lando, who was undercover all this time. I guess he does have a good heart after all. There we go. Now we can get rid of these guys. But that's pretty much the only good that can come from turrets. What you really need to do is you need to continuously build bridges from platform to platform and eventually make your way to the sailor. And just like that, we have rescued Han and Chewie, which is good because Han and Chewie are awesome. All right, let's destroy the railings. The railings, by the way, provide you with plenty of studs, so make sure you collect everything. As you can see, this true Jedi requirement is definitely on the higher side. Let's go ahead and pull down both of the levers. One thing to keep in mind is that the guards will always target the last spot that you were in. So, You can use a stick and move strategy in order to deflect their shots, but chances are you'll be busy building something and you'll get blown up like I just did. Yeah. It's sort of half and half right there. Let's go ahead and... Oh! Get away! Get! Scram! Die! Actually, that's the interjection I should use. Die! 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 Die by blaster bolt deflection. Thank you very much. Alright, that is the third turret. And by pushing this box, we will create four. All you have to do is move it into its proper place. There we go. Unfortunately, this one requires the force to use. Yeah, Luke is definitely going to be coming in handy during this chapter. And there we have it. All four turrets have been created. The minikit piece appears. But how do we get to it? Well, after destroying the railing, we need to, first of all, collect all the shinies, and then we need to deflect all of the shots. Once that all of that is over and done with, we need to use the force on these Legos and get blown up, obviously. Wow, I am sucking horribly on this chapter so far. But once we climb to the top, presto! The minikit piece is ours. There's also another minikit piece right down here, but we're not going to collect it just yet. Instead, we are going to continue our journey to Jabba's Sailor. And just like that, we have a rematch against Boba Fett. Now, in order to deal with Boba, we're going to want to use a blaster character! And hopefully, they'll be able to keep their footing much better than I can. Remember, the Gamorrean guards take two shots. Now, in terms of Boba, he's roughly the same as he was in Cloud City. I didn't even get the chance to explain the fight, but no need. Down the hatch! Ah, bounty hunters are very nutritious, you should know. But once Boba is dealt with, the other platform will come to us. Not only is Luke useful, but also Han is incredibly helpful too, because he shoots so fast. He's a great way to He's a great character to use if you want to destroy railings quickly and collect lots of studs. And even with all of that collected, we are still nowhere near halfway done. But that's okay, because this level is a bit on the longer side. Speaking of which, I should probably tell you all about some interesting history I had with this level. When I first played the original trilogy, I had made some really good progress through episodes 4 and 5. And I decided that I was only going to play a little bit of episode 6. So what happened was that I got all the way to this chapter right here, and just as I defeated Boba, the game froze. I had no idea what was going on. I tried everything. I tried unplugging my controller and putting it back in again. And I tried everything I could think of, nothing worked. I eventually had to turn off my PS2 and then turn it back on again. Well, that unfroze the game. Unfortunately, my progress was erased, and I was so upset. I could not believe what had happened. All of that work I did for nothing. So I had to replay the entire game all over again. Yeah, it sucked. But thankfully, this is the Steam version, and I don't have to deal with issues like that anymore. Okay, so what we want to do here is we want to push this box off the platform, because as you can probably figure out, yes, some Legos are inside. And these Legos, da-da-da-da, create a blaster character target. So let's go ahead and use Lando. We haven't used him in a while. But first, we'll pull down the lever. And that will cause one of the platforms to extend. Yep, that's the puzzle here. You need to find different levers and pull them down so the platforms create a bridge for you. All right, now what are we going to do next? I think we need to hit this lever? Yes, indeed. The path has been completed. So without further ado, let's go ahead and cross to the other side. Fortunately, we have finished the hard part. But, there is another I'm not telling the whole truth. There is a pretty tough part when you get to the top of the sailor, but we'll worry about that when the time comes. For now, you gotta deal with all these guards that are appearing. These guards are set number, so they won't respond. But what you need to do is you need to use the force on these panels. And once they have been revealed, you need to match the panel on the right with the panel on the left. So blue, use the force on this on the middle one, and wait, shouldn't that be complete? What's going on? Oh, the bottom light is still red. There we go, that's the way to do it. But first things first, let's go ahead and complete this target. Or build the target, I should say. Going up! Hey, fellas, how you doing? Die, 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 thank you very much. Darn, I was hoping Chewie would have ripped off the guard's arms. And I have no idea what that did. Oh well, I won't worry about it. We are now inside the sailor, and you are going to find a ton of studs in here. This is definitely a stud gold mine. As such, I would recommend using Han or Lando for their rapid-fire blaster ability. And speaking of blasters, we have a turret here. So let's go ahead and build the other one, shall we? And once that is done, and we collect all of the shinies... Ooh, check it out, we're almost halfway done with True Jedi status. Blast open the gate, and get rid of the guards. Well, that wasn't very hard. Nope, we still got a couple more to deal with. Ha! You bring an axe to a blaster fight, you're gonna get wrecked, pal. So just like in the previous room, you need to pretty much blast everything. Or at least blast the objects that can be blasted. Alright, let's go ahead and switch over to Luke, because he can use the force on this, whatever that did. Alright, there is a platform with C-3PO's face on it. We'll worry about that momentarily. Let's go ahead and build this panel, and it is out. We need to find some way to power it up. So what we're going to do is we are going to complete this battery pack. Ta-da! The terminal is now active. Let's have 3PO walk over and activate it. And that will cause the platform to rise up. Most excellent. Now here on the second floor, we've got some studs littered around, so collect them as usual. Unfortunately, that object is shiny. No way we can take care of that without a thermal detonator. We've got a wide open space. And we've got some piles of Legos lying around. First things first. Can we blast the supports? Yes, we can. So let's get that taken care of first. The supports will give you a few Lego studs, but the majority of your cash is going to come from the top of the sailor. Unfortunately, that's also where you're going to meet a crap ton of enemies. Alright, let's go ahead and collect everything there is to collect. And when that is done, use the force, and that will create a target where we can grapple up and push down the box. Before we do that, let's go ahead and build. And I just realized that I missed out on the entire stud pile. Yeah, that was real smart, wasn't it? I just realized that I have not been making very smart decisions in this chapter thus far. But it appears that we have some speakers. And that object we assembled earlier looks vaguely like a disco ball. Indeed, when we use the force on it, it attaches to the ceiling. All right. Once that is done, we've got a DJ's table. And just like that, it looks like a dance floor. I bet you know where this is going. This is, bears resemblance to the same puzzle in Attack of the Clones. Hard rock remix of the Imperial March, baby! Let's just go ahead and watch the Gamorreans jam. Come on, let's dance! Dance party! Okay, I'm bored. Let's get rid of you guys. Because you guys are terrible dancers. So the guards will continuously spawn until you, well, get out of here. Oh, Jabba is not very happy. But Princess Leia says, screw that! You overstay your welcome. Goodbye, Jabba. It's been a pleasure. Hey, R2, can you help me with the chain? Oh yeah, that's more like it. And Princess Leia is shooting guards in a bikini. Yeah, I'm gonna try to not dwell on that visual for too long. Admit it, you felt the same way when you first watched the movie. Don't lie. So there are a ton of things that we have to do here. Let's destroy that hatch and get a power-up sphere. Very, very nice. Let's also destroy all of the railings here while we have this sphere in hand. Long story short, blast everything you see. Guards, railing, breakables, anything that generates studs or hearts you need to get rid of. Now, unfortunately, the guards will continuously spawn. So you have to do various chores in order to complete the chapter. The bad news is that we gotta push this block pretty far, all whilst getting shot out by skiff guards. Alright, let's go ahead and push the battery pack right here. That's one side powered up. And let's go ahead and temporarily switch to Luke, because inside that hatch are some platforms that we can jump up to. Not only that, presto! Another blaster character target pad. Oh, darn, I just realized I had one heart, and I should have gotten the heart that dropped. Well, I'm not gonna be upset if I get blown up, but actually I will. I take that back, because look how close we are to true Jedi status. All right, let's get this thing started. Whoa! Hey buddy, how's it going? So let's go ahead and destroy these hatches. And another guard. Whoa, 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 whoa. Die, 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 die. Ow, I died instead. Oh well, four blue studs. Not the end of the world. But, take a look at that. We're so close to getting to Jedi status. I cannot tell you how many times I have played this chapter, and I just barely missed out on the true Jedi status. In fact, that probably happened the first three times I played through this chapter when I got this game. It took me about three tries before I finally obtained true Jedi status, and I was so happy when I did. Now, come on! It's the second time I've gotten blown up! Ugh. You, Skiff, guards suck. Skiffs suck. End of story. All right. The good news is that you're gonna get a ton of studs up here on the top of the ship. Obviously, there we go. It was 50,000. Wow. That is definitely one of the higher requirements. Let's place this pack right there. And that will cause the protection around the target to explode, thus revealing the tender inside. And that box's destruction, or whatever the heck it is, reveals yet another hatch. So we're gonna head down it. Come on. Will the platform please descend? Thank you. Ugh. I can't believe I'm already at 20 minutes of this level. It has taken a lot longer than I thought it would. In fact, a lot of the chapters in Return of the Jedi are on the longer side. So make sure you save some time before you tackle them. But we have this massive, I don't know what it is. Actually, it's a ramp. That's precisely what it is. We need to push the ramp in its place. And then it will move and we can use the force on it. There. Now everyone can climb up. Unfortunately, we are going to be met with more guards, so prepare yourself. All right, now that I have true Jedi status, I'm not as worried about collecting studs, so I think I can let some of them slide. There we go. And you know something? Let's go ahead and use Lando, because Lando is awesome. Let's go ahead and build this blaster character target pad. I wonder, is that like the sixth or seventh one we've built in this level? I can't believe I'm actually trying to keep track of something so insignificant, but now it's within my character. Don't judge me, I'm innocent. There we go. So let's go ahead and complete this section of the ramp. And let's go ahead and destroy the other ladder. And this section of the wall and that hatch. No real significance. This ladder is what is important. And once both are done, destroy the bars protecting the ladder. And now we can use the force to fold these sections outward. And once that is done, we can use the force on the big section to create a ramp for us. Wow, that was unnecessarily long-winded. All right, we've got a very cramped space up here with a ton of studs to collect. And cool, we broke 60,000. That's pretty awesome. Now, the bad news is that we have some guards to deal with. However, if we activate this panel right here, ta-da! The turret has been charged. Unfortunately, more guards will spawn. So using the turret, we destroy both of the targets, and everything has been taken care of. Jabba has been defeated. Han has been rescued. And everyone is saved. Come on, guys. You can make it. Well, I guess not. Whoa! C-3PO took the plunge, didn't he? And that is it for the Solar Sailor. Okay, it wasn't quite as epic an explosion as the Death Star was, but, you know, give it credit. Anyway, with the level complete and free play unlocked, we have unlocked Lando, Palace Guard, and Princess Leia, Slave. We've almost completed our second row of characters. 100% true Jedi status, that's always nice. And we have got some more studs. We've already hit the 2 million mark. No way we're gonna pass 3 million, but we'll see how much more we get. Alright, that is it. Or maybe we will pass 3 million, I don't know. But one thing I do know is that this is gonna be the end of the video. So next time on Let's Play Lego Star Wars The Complete Saga, we are going to continue our adventure in Return of the Jedi. See you guys next time.
Hey, did you like what you saw? Then be sure to follow me on Facebook and Twitter for updates on my videos. Also, do you want to record LP videos like me? Then check out my kit page for my go-to equipment for recording.